Images showing thousands of migrants, mostly children, packed inside a migrant facility on the U.S. southern border. The stunning footage of children sleeping on mats in overcrowded plastic pods. That was captured inside a temporary Customs and Border Protection facility, this in Donna, Texas, yesterday. Our next guest has a background in documenting the horrific conditions at the U.S. border. She's down there now filming footage for a sequel to a documentary on illegal immigration she produced last year. Namrata Singh Gujral, documentary filmmaker, joining us now to talk a little bit more about her film and, of course, react to the new images that we're seeing there. Namrata, there was outrage, as we recall, from media outlets, politicians, when those images first emerged during the Trump administration. Keep in mind now the new images that we're seeing, these children being packed into these small containers, sort of looking facilities. Of course, it's during COVID, too, during a pandemic. What's your reaction to seeing these children and the conditions that they're really facing?
Well, first of all, thank you for having me. I will tell you my reaction is I was actually not laughing in a funny way, like, haha, funny. But, you know, all this, my previous picture talked about the caravans. I don't know if you guys remember the big hoopla around the caravans. And so now what we're seeing is not 10 times worse, it's 100 times worse. And I'm just thinking, oh my God, there was all that hoopla around the caravans. I just want to know, where is AOC? Because we actually showed that in America's Forgotten, AOC wandering through the places in San Diego, making her comments. And so the one thing that kept occurring to me as I was in San Diego was, where is AOC?
Mm-hmm. No, so true. So many people, I think, recall the image of her in sort of the white outfit looking outside of the cages, and they're waiting for a similar reaction. I think we saw briefly a video she released last night criticizing the word surge when describing the number of migrants at their southern border. Do you think surge is an accurate reflection of what we're seeing right now, considering the number of immigrants trying to cross into the United States?
I think, I mean, you've got to be blind, I think, to not be cognizant of the numbers that are coming in and the pictures you're looking at. I come from a background of filmmaking, and a picture speaks 1,000 words. So, yeah, I mean, you can call it a surge, or you can call it a catastrophe at the border, or you can call it an open border crisis. It's all the same thing. There's too many people coming in seeking asylum that don't have the right to asylum. And I want to talk about that in terms of a little difference that I found shooting this picture versus the other in terms of the attitude of the migrants. But yeah, I mean, I would say if you put it nicely, it's a surge, yes.
Yeah, well, tell me about that difference, because you have experience covering immigration as well as illegal immigration. Tell me what you're finding under the Biden administration.
So the big difference that we're finding is when we shot America's Forgotten and we interviewed a lot of these migrants. And by the way, these people, they truly, they're coming here, and I don't want to sort of show them as victims. I'm not saying they're necessarily victims, but in some ways, they are victims of America's messaging and Biden's messaging. So the first picture that we shot, we found that there was a lot of sense of trepidation around them. And this time, what was a little bit disturbing almost to me was a sense of, I would say, entitlement. So I'll give you an example. When you ask them now, hey, so you're at the border, so what do you hope is going to happen? They say, they need to let me in. This is someone like wearing a Biden t-shirt, maybe. They need to let me in. And I'm going, well, I've become a little bit of an expert at asylum qualification. So I'm like, okay, well, we just went through your checklist. What if you're denied? Because it sounds like you don't really have any poverty or persecution or all of the other things that they look at when they give you asylum. And hands down, pretty much everyone said to me, yeah, but it's our right. Biden told us to come here, so it's our right to get in. It's almost like this time they're feeling, well, it's my right. You're shutting me out. And it's like Biden should have probably not given them that idea.
Yeah, you say sort of a promise that was made when just listening to the president and him addressing and talking about immigration. Very fascinating, the work you're doing. Check it out, americasforgottenmovie.com. That's Namrata Singh Gujral joining us live here on National Report. Namrata, thank you.
Hey, thanks so much. And the movie can be caught on Salem now.
Okay, we'll check it out. Thanks so much.
Well, it's been a rough time for President Biden.